everyone knows the top command in Linux, the go-to tool for monitoring system processes. Often, people use it to find out which processes are eating up the CPU. But did you know that top has a bunch of hidden options and shortcuts that most Linux users never use? In this video, I'll show you some of those lesser-known tricks to make your system monitoring much more powerful. Here we go. Let's start by the options first. The first option is minus I. With minus I, you ignore the idle processes. So, top command will start by hiding idle and zombie processes. Later on, it will resume to the normal state, but initially, you will only see the processes that are actually doing the work, ignoring the inactive processes. If you want to monitor only your processes or a specific users, use minus U. Much cleaner than scrolling endlessly. Next, with minus H, capital H, top breaks down each process into its threads. Super useful for debugging multi-threaded apps. You can also use top to monitor only specific processes. This limits top to only the process IDs you care about, instead of flooding you with all the processes running on the system. And the next one is my favorite. Sorting top by memory. By default, top sorts by CPU, but with minus O, you can sort by memory or actually any other metric, and you can do it interactively as well. That I will show you in the next section. Top command has a very useful but highly underutilized interactive mode. For example, by default, top only shows the process name. If you press the C key while top is running, it expands to the full command line. So you see exactly how the process was launched. Similarly, with Shift plus V, you get a process hierarchy, like PS minus F command output. It's great to understand which processes spawned others. And here comes my favorite, sorting columns. Like by default, top command shows you the top CPU consuming processes. You can sort it by most memory consuming processes by pressing Shift plus M. This is what I showed you earlier, but this time you're doing it interactively. In fact, you can sort it by any column. Press the F key and it opens the field management option. Use the array keys to move down to the desired field. Press S to sort by it. You can see the sorted field on the top. Once selected, press the escape key and you'll notice that it now sorts by your selected field. Now, it is difficult to figure out which column is being sorted in the regular top view. So press X key and it highlights the sorted column. Yes, it's still not that easy, but it's a little bit better to see which columns is being sorted. If you don't want to see system daemons and root processes, press U and filter by user. Much cleaner when you're debugging your own work. You use top to find the processes which are consuming the most resources. And when you find them, you might want to kill them in some cases. Now, you can kill a process interactively from the top command itself just by pressing K and entering the process ID. You can see the process ID in the top command output. So it makes things a lot easier to do it this way rather than going through the command line again and using kill command, isn't it? At any point, if you feel lost in the interactive mode, and it is easy to be so, remember that help is just a key away, and that key is H. Press H and the help option shows the keys you can use interactively. Top command doesn't have to run continuously forever. You can run it in batch mode, and it creates a snapshot of all running processes at that moment. Great for saving process snapshots to a file or using in scripts. This is just a glimpse of what top command can do. It's an extensive command with tons of features. I mean, look at its man page that goes for thousands of lines. It is not immediately evident that top command can be used interactively. Probably the reason why htop, ptop, and several other system monitoring tools are preferred for more interactive users. I hope you learned something new in this video. Perhaps you will use it to sort by memory or kill a process interactively. Which feature did you like the most here? Share it in the comments, please, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.